down there with you?
It's George Bailey, Mother.
George Bailey? What's he want?
I don't know. What do you want?
Me? Not a thing. I just came in to get warm.
As we scan up, this is the view from behind our apartment. Let me move back a little bit. Stand on my tiptoes. You can see Morgan Road, Liverpool, New York. The Joseph F. Pietrafesa Company, Incorporated. Exciting. One of the things that we're most proud of living here in apartment one is the close proximity of the dumpster to our apartment. There's the Valiant. Notice that this is our parking lot. There's the Valiant. The Honda is conspicuously absent. There's our friend the dumpster again. As we swing back around, there's our bush and there's our stoop. I forgot to pick up. Driving slowly. Someone behind me now. I don't think it's a policeman though. As I get to the stop sign, we'll turn right. Joseph P. Stresser Company over there. We are in Liverpool Park. There's the direction we just came from by the church, Presbyterian Church. It was parked in downtown Liverpool, where Paul and Karen live, not the home of the Beatles. And across the street there is the Liverpool Library, which has allowed us to have this, but close up the library. So you can see the sign now, Liverpool Library. There's a library. Maybe it's a librarian going in. Okay, I'll swing a little bit over here. Down there is Lake Onondaga. Old OD Liverpool shop. We'll get out there in a second. Now we're looking the other direction. That's the park where I was. Downtown Liverpool. Really exciting. Looking down the street. Here is the mobile station. Here's my gas pump. Post office, Liverpool, New York, where you get all these cards and letters. Onondaga Lake. There's some ducks down there. This is a lake that's right near downtown Liverpool where we just were. If you look down this way, there's Syracuse. There's the Carrier Dome. To the left there of the Carrier Dome is Carousel Mall, where my wife is at this moment. There's a bird. There's some other buildings there. Not sure what those are. There's churches. This all goes around here, wraps around. Over there, towards this way over here is where the state fairgrounds are. They have the New York State Fair. This is a marina, actually. No. Go right to the sun. The wind whipped today. It's cold today. It's about 42 degrees. Cool. Of course, I'm dressed inappropriately. You hear it? And there it is today. The boarding on the lake are nice houses. Neat houses. Some kind of cream thing there. As you can also see, there's people walking. There's a walking track. It goes all around the lake. They have jogging, and winter they have cross-country skiing on it, and Karen and I are looking forward to doing that. There's another kind of boat-like thing. Bye. Here's one of the Liverpool landmarks. Hyde's. Food you'll like. There's the sign. Food you'll like. They have, Karen can correct me on this, I think they have hot dogs, slaw, buns, beans. That's it. Food you'll like. Okay, that's showing where I was earlier at the lake. There's the walking trail. That's where I was. There's the walking trail. There's people walking down there. And this is like the office park. This is the Salt Sea Museum. Syracuse is called the Salt City. Because I guess they had a lot of salt here. Almost to me. But I will know one of these days. I'm not a good job there. Park the sun there. And it's just a parking lot. Finally, 7 weeks. There it is, Jim Service Center. No Honda. Okay, now we're going down. See the butt truck? Heading south from Hyde's. Going to be caring for lunch at the mall. Still 30 miles an hour. Lake on our right. That's where we just were near there. Griffin Field, where Liverpool plays their games. Holiday Inn lights. Now becomes 55 miles per hour. It's a beautiful day for filming, don't you think? Except the sun's probably shining right in the camera's face. There's nothing I can do about that. Slap down. Okay. There's the lake again. Is the truck dock, and there are the doors which Karen and I come in and out in the mall. Isn't that exciting? Yes. The main entrance to Carousel Commons. Now back up. Carousel Center. Beautiful, isn't it? Nothing like a mall. Bonwit Teller. Very pretentious clothing store. And I believe it's time to eat. So this, we bid you adieu, and I will come back. I will have a full stomach. Now I'm recording. This is Sam Scarviello, another inmate at, where's that place?
Williams-Sonoma.
All right, I have a question to ask. If you had a choice of partying with Two Live Crew or New Kids on the Block, what would you choose?
Two Live Crew.
Okay, and how does that fit in with Williams-Sonoma?
It's hell.
Say one word to describe Williams-Sonoma. Okay, that says it all.
Think of something remotely nice to say about.
We can chat with you with the mall in the background. It's nice, isn't it? There it is.
The Temple of Syracuse.
Do you have anything nice to say about my wife?
She looks for projects.
Okay, that's it.
I mean, do you actually play all these, or...?
Well, I play them, and I cherish them. Mm-hmm. This is at the top of the heap right here. There's no question about it. Look at the flame on that one.
Yes.
I mean, it's just... It's quite unbelievable. This one is just... it's perfect. 1959. You know, it just... You can... listen.
How much is this?
Just listen for a minute. The sustain. Listen to it.
I'm not hearing anything.
You would, though, if it were playing, because it really... It's famous for its sustain. I mean, you can just hold it.
Well, I mean, so you'd have to...
You can go and have a bite. No, you'd still be hearing that one.
Yeah.
Can you hold it a sec?
Be sure.
This one, this, of course, is a custom 3 pickup. Paul, this is my radio unit.
Oh,
so I strap this piece on, you know, right down in here when I'm on stage.
It's wireless.
Wireless, exactly. Yeah. And I can play without all the mucky.
You can run anywhere on
exactly
stage with that.
This is special too, isn't it? Look, see? Still got the old tagger on it. See, never even played it.
See? You just bought it.
Don't touch it. Don't touch it.
I wasn't going to touch it.
No, don't touch it.
I was just pointing at it.
Well, don't point even.
Don't even point.
No, it can't be played. Never. I mean,
can I look at it?
No. No, you've seen enough of that one. This is a top to, you know, what we use on stage, but it's very, very special because if you can see, the numbers all go to 11. Look, right across the board, 11, 11,
and most of 11, these and then amps go up to 10.
Exactly.
Does that mean it's louder? Is it any louder?
Well, it's one louder, isn't it? It's not 10. You see, most blokes are going to be playing at 10. You're on 10 here, all the way up, all the way up, all the way up. You're on 10 on your guitar. Where can you go from there? Where?
I don't know.
Nowhere, exactly. What we do is if we need that extra push over the cliff, you know what we do?
Put it up to 11.
11, exactly. One louder.
Why don't you just make 10 louder and make 10 be the top number and make that a little louder?
These go to 11.
Blue Jays franchise, and where I will spend many, many days in the summer. And over there is the parking lot where Karen and I used to get to work. We'd park in there and take a shuttle every morning to go to work at Williams. Let's see, it's located on top of a building. Some reason that they have something in the deed that said the house could not be moved, so instead they put the house on top of the building. I'm getting into downtown Syracuse now. There's some dudes playing round ball. Lombardi's famous grocery store, Fruits and Imports. Peter's grocery over here. Another big Italian grocery store. Let's see what Peter's has got today. Filet's Cook's Own Tips. Big bologna. For an ice melt. And of course, the ever-present rockery tickets. Okay, here we are in Normal Street. Just in the Italian part of town. There's a church. Here is the Busa Bakery, where oftentimes Karen and I come and get some baked goods. So you can see the bread in there now. There's a customer. They're buying bread at her Goose's. And she's nice enough to let me film here. It's downtown Syracuse. I'm not sure what this building is right here, but I went there to apply for a personnel job there, or an employment job. The architecture down here is kind of neat because it's old. It's a kind of statue or something like that. That's probably monument and woolly. Back around here. We're in front of the Syracuse newspaper building right there. So I just wanted to let you know. Feel for the city. Down one more intersection. Another building. It's got a restaurant at the bottom called Nicky's. Still down downtown Syracuse. Okay, here's another. It's called Armory Square. It's a little trendy kind of place that's starting off. Lots of businesses. Right down there, there used to be a sign. You can still see it. I don't think it's there anymore. For Woolies Antiques. Let's go. There's a little place. We came to our first, one of the first places that, one of the places that I went to. That other place I showed you, the building that had the employment agency in there. This is what he came up with. Just wanted to have somebody run this business for, with option to buy. that she would still be in direct control. Karen and I thought that over, we decided it was too much of a risk. Okay, it's Syracuse University now. Actually, it's part of it. See how good it. Let him once again delay. There it is, the famed Acropolis. And right next door. Karen's interview. Snow's coming. Stormbrew. You can tell Syracuse is kind of hilly. Syracuse do right now. Click on there. Lost horizon. And one of my favorite shots. Carousel Mall, the anchor store, Bonwit Teller, and more importantly, the big Hess gas drum right beside the mall. There she is. Thanks. Say hi to everybody in North Carolina.
Hi.
Hey, you're supposed to say hey.
Hey, y'all.
Bye.
Fine, I didn't realize it was so late.
Hey, what'd you do? Break a bottle of shaving lotion?
You're kidding. I'm wearing too much.
Well, it's a touch strong. Not terrible, though. Once we get out into the air, you won't even notice it.
I better set this place up quickly.
The place is fine. We're just going to have a quick drink and go.
If you carefully place out, we'll create the proper impression.
You're not going to leave those half-open books lying around like you're reading them.
Why not? It creates an image.
Alan, you don't need an image.
See? Just the thing, my 100-yard dash medal.
Oh, you're joking. You're not going to leave out a track medal.
Why not? I paid $20 for it. I got a big decision to make here.
Yeah.
Do I go with Oscar Peterson or Bartok String Quartet number 5?
Why don't you play your Oscar Peterson and leave Bartok out so that everybody can see it?
It's a good idea.
You know, I've never seen anybody go to so much trouble to impress a date, particularly such a casual date. I mean, if you devoted this much time and interest with Nancy, I don't see why she left you.
I did. I used to write her poems and take her to candlelight restaurants and order in French. And the waiter would bring all the wrong things.
Maybe if you just leaned across the candlelight and kissed her.
I tried. She used to say, Christ, not here, everybody staring. And once a little bistro on Union Street, my sleeve caught fire. See, you laugh. It's funny, right? She took it as a symbol of my clumsiness, which I guess it was.
Oh.
Tremendous poise. I'm an absolute master.
This is Sharon.
Hello. I was just telling Dick I've got friends on this block in the house right across the street. You know the Gibsons?
Gibsons, no.
Hal and Eleanor Gibson. They're a fantastic couple. He's an interior decorator.
Oh, really? That's sort of a hobby of mine.
Oh. Uh-huh.
The key to interior decorating is to avoid looking like you used a decorator.
I've got to make one quick call.
Linda, are you wearing jasmine?
Me?
Well, let's see now. What are we drinking?
I'll have a J&B on the rocks.
I'll have a little Harvey's Bristol, please.
I'll have the usual. Bourbon and water.
Oh, a bourbon man.
I gotta cut down on my drinking. I'm beginning to put away a quart a day.
Christie, I'm no longer at 431-5997. I'm going to be at Mr. Fee. What time did that come in? Yeah.
Sharon did a movie.
Oh?
Underground.
Stag film?
Underground. You know, very arty. 16 millimeter.
Yes, well, Alan is interested in cinema.
Oh, really? What do you do?
I'm a writer. Nothing much for Film Weekly. Articles, essays, criticism.
Oh, this film I did got very good reviews. As a matter of fact, I got singled out. Of course, I was the only girl in it with 9 men.
Really? What's it called? Maybe I saw it.
Gangbang. You know, these films have the raunchiest titles. Really, it wasn't a bit sexy.
You were all out of bourbon, so I made it straight water. Well, it's so humid out, I think it's going to rain.
Maybe that's why I've got this headache. I get terrible sinus attacks.
You should have them drained.
That's why it's silly to go to the pier.
Do you think you could turn the music down a little bit?
Of course.
What's the point of going to an outdoor restaurant if it's going
to
rain?
You used to like to take me walking in the rain.
I love the rain. It washes memories off the sidewalk of life.
Oh! Gee, Alan, you really have a delicate touch.
Alan is a trifle tense. He had a little misfortune with his wife.
His wife?
Well, his ex-wife. She's gone.
She's dead.
How old? Well, no, she's not really dead.
No, no. Technically not dead, but we're not dating.
She left him.
I'm sorry.
Quiet. No.
On anything?
Well, he's been under some strain lately.
Now, hi, this is Mr. Christie. I'm at the Hong Fat Noodle Company. That's 824-7996. Yeah, right. Okay, bye-bye.
Well, let me tell you what's really interesting is when they eat rice with chopsticks authentically, they kind of bring it up to their mouth like this, and it's kind of a shoveling move that you get with your arm, you know, just sort of...
What's the matter?
Would you excuse me?
Home now.
Go back.
There's Karen. She's my wife. And what's Karen wearing for our special occasion? The buffalo sweatshirt with the hole
in it. And sweatpants. Also, we couldn't wear that. He said, are you going to wear that to be filmed? I said, yes. So now the tour begins.
She said yes because someone said that the mall is going to collapse at Carousel Mall. That some psychic in California said it was going to collapse. So that Karen said she would die and she wanted people to remember her the way she was.
So for all you sweats and videotape, this is what I wear around home. Speak.
Oh, there's a cat.
He's trained.
Where is he? Then we'll go.
Come here. Speak. Sit.
The cat spoke and sat.
He's very well trained. No rabbit. Hypnotized now.
He is the smartest cat we have. He is the only smart cat we have. He disagrees. There will be many cats on this video, so you better get used to it. Not you. There's the cat trainer again.
Speak. He's a ham.
Try one more time.
Speak.
No.
George.
Wait a minute. Here comes another. This is the spokes cat. He's the one that usually relates to what all the other cats would like. We call him Scritch. Scritch!
Sure.
Now there's cat petting going on.
Wait.
Isn't she just lovely?
Now moving on into the dining room.
Okay. Well, actually, we'll start our tour. We'll start our tour. Goodbye.
Go?
Yes, we're ready to go.
To begin our tour, we'll start in the entrance. Here's the entrance.
I'm at the entrance now.
You're just here with us.
So if you were to begin the entrance, you first walk in the door, then you see steps leading to who knows where. Actually, they lead to upstairs. And then we have a little cart stand here in our foyer for the time being because we're still in massive renovation mess.
with a just a beautiful plant beside it. And a cat. Then there's Karen there. We have our furniture arranged thusly with blinds. We have very large windows, as you saw from the previous, with blinds that don't quite meet the bottom. TV, coffee table. Trivial Pursuit game, very important. As you can tell, nothing as of yet on the walls. Karen, would you like to take over from this point? Karen keeps pointing at the cats.
George.
George is the only one that's not scared of things. He likes the vacuum cleaner. There's another plant. One of two new plants we have. There's our beautiful stereo setup. We're actually not too fond of that.
Plant number three.
Oh, I just lost my hand. We have plant number three. We're there. As you can see, Karen, beside the plant. Moving on into the dining room.
Which is occupied by
our new friend.
Unpacked boxes and our new friend, Mr. Computer.
To the side of the dining room, we have the desk that my sister Carol gave us with things on it. Cappuccino machine. Briefcase.
More unpacked boxes.
Briefcase for getting jobs. We're not getting jobs. Our new friend, the computer that Jim and Jane have graciously let us use. The smoker has not yet been used for smoking. Unpack boxes, and we will show you what we're doing with that later. Now we go to the kitchen. Most important thing in the kitchen, of course, is the full-length New Kids on the Block on the refrigerator door. Jordan, Jonathan, Donnie, Danny, and Joe. Now, there's my wife. We do have something on the wall there, a pot holder. We have one thing on the wall, a pot holder. I'll step into the kitchen now. At the other entrance to the kitchen, there's my wife again. She's not doing anything, she's just standing there. There's Kat again. There's the refrigerator. There's our counter space, it's metallic. Karen, would you like to say anything about the kitchen?
My herb garden, oregano, basil. And the view of Morgan, and the lovely view of Joseph P. Efestra clothing and Morgan Road.
Beautiful. Yeah. Just beautiful. Oh, nice basil. There's a cat. Morgan Road out there. It supposedly will be snowing tonight.
Hi.
There's my wife again. There's our stove, just like the other stove we had. Friday on top will be used. You all see in a few minutes. Then we have another little table that Jay and Jim got for us at a yard sale. We're not exactly sure what we're going to do with this kitchen space yet. There's the pot holder.
There's Lily standing in her cat dish.
There's Karen. Now there's the other door where I was with our friend the computer. There's Wally standing in the cat dish to drink. Not a smart animal. Speaking of, this is a little item here we picked up at the Salvation Army. And Karen started to paint it. She hasn't finished it yet. She's done a lovely job. It didn't look nearly as good as it did that she started. And on top of it, it's my pride and joy. Toast oven, yard sale, $3. To the left, our microwave oven with under top of the old sewing machine. Oh, there goes Wooly springing into the picture. And Wooly on top of her favorite place. Our new dishwasher, portable dishwasher that Jane and Jim gave us.
And a lifetime supply of aluminum foil.
And you, Alcoa, Lube Company of America, I believe.
Christina, New York.
Lynn Fitkin knows where that is. Molly's favorite place to be. Molly, say something for the camera. Molly's not real smart. She'll rub her face on anything, though. She's very excited about seeing herself on TV.
Molly.
Now, moving right along, we'll go out this door. Oops. Got a wide angle back a little bit. Okay, wide angle back. And there's the living area again. If we come over here, you'll see our front door as we came out earlier. There's the air conditioner. We don't need that now. Karen, would you turn on the bathroom light, please?
Here's the bathroom, yay!
This is the bathroom. It smells like vanilla in here for some reason we haven't figured it out. There it is. Basically a
standard garden party bathroom. Down to the basement.
Down to the basement. I will film the basement stairs, but not while I'm going down, because I do not want to drop the camera. So I'll meet you at the basement. Nice picture of the wall. Now I'm at the basement, I'm turning around. And there's our cat litter, which we will not really focus in on for obvious reasons. There's bookshelves that I am attempting to make for the upstairs. There is the headboard to the bed that Faye gave Karen and I. Karen's painting it, and then she's going to paint it some other color. Some pickled pine color. Here is our buffet. We also got this at the Salvation Army. We're refinishing it, and that is one of the reasons why we have to move boxes, because we're going to refinish it and then
put it in the dining room
and probably move the other desk upstairs.
It's our $15 buffet.
$15. Great deal. This, of course, Wake Forest paraphernalia on the wall. Karen's very fond of that. The fish. In the Wake Forest license plate. Besides the behind the buffet, we have some shelves that are littered with things. Karen's dad came down and we built these shelves. Actually, he did it. I just kind of watched them. And we unpacked all our boxes and put everything on here. We haven't had time to clean it up yet. And since we just built the shelves a little bit ago. And there's some more things in the back. There's a cat. That chair is peering out at us. Oh, there he goes. This, Karen, out of the way. High chair that Karen's refinishing. So we have lots of little projects doing, but we haven't finished any of them. There's our washer and dryer. Well, actually, there's the tumbler. It's a dryer that tumbles but does not dry in the washer, which works great.
Rosebud.
There's our tub. There's the rosebud sled, which we will get out later and use. Now, moving right along.
Another, you notice the cats like to be down here when we're down here.
Another yard sale item. This desk, $6. And more shelving. Karen bending over.
Hey!
Perfect timing. Karen is a cat addict. Think of cats. Always talking to empty boxes. And that's our basement. Downstairs closet.
Winter clothes.
Clothes. Boxes. Winter clothes, yes. Things to be hung. That will be cleared off later for hats. That will be cleared off later for boots. We're upstairs now. Top of the hall. Here's our bathroom. Here's Karen yawning.
Here's the Buffalo Bill sweatshirt.
Bill sweatshirt. Towels.
Towel and
Karen
floor.
Starts to clean. Towel and floor.
For the tub
we
drips.
Know what that is. And here I am. And let's
sink.
Don't take a picture of the laundry.
Yeah, the laundry. I'm sorry. Okay, now we move over there. Here's the downstairs. As you can see, door. Here's one bedroom. Not much in it. Dresser. There's our
guest bedroom.
Guest bed, which is awaiting what Karen is refinishing. There's a box. I don't know why it's in there. And some of our lovely box furniture, which the lamp sits on. There's a closet. Anything, this is my closet. I usually keep my stuff in. And now we'll go back out to the next one. Going down the hall. There's Karen again. This is the largest room. This cat's following us around constantly. Especially this one. Which is more important, this or this? I think we know the answer to that. There is another table we got at yard sale. $15. And we will put the computer on there when friends come to visit. And it's also the sewing machine up there. Book desk. We are still trying to renovate this room. And we're going to do some different things with it. We're not sure why. Couch is in there. The... What was that thing called?
Drawing table.
Oh, yeah. Drawing table. It's in there. Another cat down there.
And the birds live in the air conditioner over there.
TV, file cabinet. Dresser. Wife. And birds living in the air conditioner. Another closet. Not worth getting into. The last bedroom.
Hi,
no. She just did. Isn't she funny? As usual, the cat's in here.
Make him get on the bed. Norge. Where's the train? Come here. Here he is.
And there's the other closet.
There he is. Train.
And there's the cat.
Train, get on the bed.
Okay.
Warm and cuddly, and they're ready for you to take them home. Meet Frick and Frack, our Save-A-Pets of the Week, ready for adoption at the Guilford County Animal Shelter. Now, this brother-sister pair are your typical kittens, very curious and playful, as you can see, and you can adopt them together or separately.
We say they're probably around 4 months old. They have had the first two series of their shots, but would need the third series and, of course, their feline leukemia test.
And remember, the adoption fee you pay includes spaying and neutering by a local veterinarian. And if you're interested in taking a look at Frick and Frack, you can see them tomorrow at the Guilford County Animal Shelter. It opens at 11:30 in the morning. It's located at 4525 West Wendover Avenue in Greensboro, or you can call 373-7561, the high point number 884-7561.
Now, how can you resist
them? They're cute. They're cute as they can be.
The stewardess said...
Both pilots.
Can you fly this plane and land it?
Surely you can't be serious.
I am serious. And don't call me Shirley.
Doctor, I've checked everyone. Mr. Stryker's the only one.
What flying experience have you had?
Oh, I flew single-engine fighters in the Air Force, but this plane has four engines. It's an entirely different kind of flying, altogether.
It's an entirely different kind of flying.
There's the bacon cat. Harry. There's the plain cat, who's obsessed with anything under the refrigerator.
He's obsessed with twist ties.
Is there a spot of dirt on there?
Spot of dirt on what?
On the lens.
Don't know. There's the bacon cat. Squid. Look. Squid. We're preparing the calamari, fried calamari. Have to
either
tonight, because we don't eat enough.
How do you
zoom
here?
Ouch. Now
the cats are scavenging for their food in the cupboard.
The alcohol kicks the cat at the cupboard door. It says, no, bad cat.
What are you making, Paul?
Tonight, our appetizer is...
I don't know if I... That's easier. Here, the cats think that when we eat, they should eat too. So even though they've been fed, they're eating again. Except for Baking Cat. Baking Cat.
Raggy Squid. Who likes them? Cutting Squid up. Cat is begging. He will not get any.
Harry. Harry. What do you want?
Now I try the pitiful meow approach. Never works. Oh, while you're here, I'll show my bread. This is the bread that we got today at Ragusa Bakery.
It's very good. It's very fresh.
Go. You can tell it's semolina bread. It looks yellow because it's semolina flour. But my friend. Also, we got... I probably could have gone inside and filmed, but the woman was very nice. I told her what I was going to film outside. That I didn't want to embarrass her. She's an old table. These are almond what? Cookies?
I don't know. Those are...
Something almond. They're good.
Almonds. No, like almond cinnamon cookies.
Cinnamon almonds. Is that correct?
Yep.
Cinnamon almond cookies. They're very good. Got those there, too. I'm going to take some lemon cookies, but I figured out enough.
And the bread cost like what, 69 cents for
everything
the
roll? Cost three cookies and the bread cost $1.02. Which is very nice.
Okay, we're going to take a break now because my arm's getting tired.
And then we will come. When you come back, you will see us flouring calamari. Karen Calamari. Karen is currently
filming
my pants. Take it back. Put flour in.
Back up. Should we zoom in? I hope this is in focus.
You can autofocus if you want.
Isn't it on autofocus, isn't it?
I mean, you can manually focus if you'd like.
Don't set yourself on fire.
I'm not. Flour. Salt, just a little salt. Pepper. We don't use too much pepper in our cooking. Paprika. Red pepper. Anything else we'll put in there, Karen?
No.
The Cajun spices today? Try a little Cajun spice in there. See what happens.
Extreme close up. Mm-hmm.
California bag. Whoops. Let's check it out. Karen loves the cat. Hey, I'm cooking over here. Look at those stupid cats.
Harry.
Look, I'm putting the live calamari in here now. You might want to get this on film. As hard as it is, to break away. Live calamari.
It's dead.
And flour and whatever else you'd like. Any other spices. Hey! Turn that camera back over here.
Wooly!
The person who's obsessed with cats.
Close up, Wooly!
Meanwhile. Perhaps put all the calamari.
No, we have it.
Chill in. Cat obsessed person. Ah. Tell that. It's too late now.
Let's see. Where are you?
Let's see. Where am I? Friday. Calamari. Poplars. Without Katie Poplars around. There's three. They're starting a collection. We haven't been able to collect anything lately. So I feel once I turn 30, I start collecting stuff. Poplars from all these sides. Another important thing about our kitchen over here. Always need to have plenty of fireballs around. Don't tell me, come with fireballs. Fireballs right here. You have plenty of fireballs around all over. Now we'll fill stir out with the quick top.
Okay.
you're not going to be holding the twist tie.
I can't get all of you in the shot.
Sir, I was twist tie obsessed. He bats around constantly. That's exciting.
Snow rabbit!
Looking almost done.
Zoom in on that calamari. Tilt the plate.
That's a good stuff, a gone feed.
There it is.
Cajun calamari.
There it is. Zoom in, close up, now back up.
Oh, would you like some?
Okay. Snow rabbit. Snow rabbit.
Okay, enough of that. We're at the computer. Say your new time.
This is a typical evening in the Fincan household.
Here,
Ella Fitzgerald singing in the background, and Paul working at the computer.
Mouse, prodigy. Now we're tapping into our communication system software, prodigy. Here, please. Camera woman. Please, camera woman. I've got to show you this. This is very sacred to Karen and I and the cradles. This is the ceramic cowl butter dish made by Julie, which we have converted into the Trivial Pursuit prize. Normally there would be a shriveled up potato in here. 5 years ago when Karen and I were living in Greensboro, Jim and Jane came to visit. And Jim had a potato that he strapped to his knee because he was having some kind of arthritis. And he said that having a potato strapped to your knee would help. Well, the rest of us thought this was very funny. So Karen and I saved this potato and is now shriveled. And we have saved it and saved it. So now it has become our prize for winning the Trivial Pursuit between the men and the women. As you see, there's no potato here because Jim and I lost last game, and Jim, the potato bandit, has taken the potato and gone somewhere with it. We don't know. He keeps leaving us clues for the prodigy where we might find the potato. We have nothing to look at. So we'll let you know if you come visit. Don't break this. There's a cat looking for twist ties, although there are three twist ties on the floor over there. What she does best.
Close up!
Helps if you know your words.
You're right.
Go out. Okay, I'm on now. Oh, I have to stand up, you know. There I am. And now I would like to play a song that I've recently discovered that this song was sung by Sarah Fallon to Karen. And, Harry and I would like to act this song out a little bit. This is Ella Fitzgerald singing Harmony Berlin. Song by Sarah Fallon to Harry.
You can have him. I don't want him, he's not worth fighting for. Besides, there's plenty more where he came from. I don't want him, you can have him. I'm giving him the sack. And
Sarah's
go right back where he came from. I could never make him happy.
happy.
She never could.
We'll be better off with you. I'm afraid I never loved him. All I ever wanted to do was run my fingers through his curly locks, mend his underwear and darn his socks, fetch his slippers and remove his shoes, wipe his glasses when he read the news, rub his forehead with a gentle touch, mornings after when he's had too much, kiss him gently when he comes near, give him babies one for every year, so you see.
For Harry either.
Him. I don't want him. He's not worth fighting for. Besides, there's plenty more where he came from. I don't want him. You can't have him. He isn't my concern. And he can just return where he came from. I would look a trifle silly taking him away from you. That was never my intention. All I ever wanted to do was close the window while he soundly slept, ring the icebox where the food is kept, cook a breakfast that would please him most, egg and coffee and some buttered toast, wake him gently with a breakfast tray, after breakfast clear the things away, bring the papers and when they've been read, spend the balance of the day in bed. You see,
I'm sorry. Isn't it?
Sarah Fallon saying that's all caring about me. While you're there, are you still there? I'd like to show you what we're getting our friend Baruch. Some people call him as Daruj for Christmas. So far we have three things for him. A Partridge Family Christmas card starring Shirley Jones featuring David Cassidy. We sing Frosty the Snowman, Rockin' Around the Christmas Tree. Good stuff. Disco Noel. This has to be heard to believe. Be believed. If you haven't lived, you've heard Silent Night in disco. Hot stuff. Also, something from a friend of his.
Six. Six.
Persian language.
Four. Chahar. Chahar. Five. Hang.
Hang. Karen and I are going to learn
six.
Farsi.
Shish.
Shish.
Please!
down your guns.
Say something to us.
Say something to you? I was born in 1958 in an Elkin, small town in North Carolina. I mean that I've lived in four decades now, the '50s, the '60s, the '70s, and the '80s, five decades. I'm 32 years old, but I've lived in 5 decades. Quite amazing, I think. Of course, well, for our life, I think it's been
Say great. Something interesting to us.
I was talking about myself. I thought that was pretty interesting. That's what I thought. Let's see. Past, I worked at CIA. Cradle! Karen, would you like to read?
I feel like George Winston checked the other artists that record under the Windham Hill label. Over the past several years, this has become so popular that most record stores devote an entire section to the artists recording in the Windham Hill series. You might also take a look. Soundtrack from the movie Country. Winston plays on this extensively, and the music is very stress relieving. Karen in Syracuse.
Who's awfully? Who's this?
Karen in Syracuse. Via hello, me. Okay. Did anyone get any replies?
No, you were a reply. Say bye, Karen. Isn't she cute?
Cuckoo.
There's Scratch, the begging cat. As you can probably hear, we're starting to cook supper now. Cooking pizza night. We chose this especially because we're turning into Italian people up here. And because it seems like they need a lot of. I don't know, we've not yet figured out.
Zoom shot.
No, she's made a big mess. That's one thing I found out about being a cat owner. If you're going to be a cat owner, be used to having a mess.
He eats the whole mushroom, but he leaves just like little chewed pieces.
Well, that's what it does, to have the have a mess. To have our little Harry.
The cat, he's a vegetarian cat.
Looking at some of the things people write about.
My favorite part.
The subject is Young and Restless. Cricket in swimsuit. And this is the reply from Joyce to Christine Erickson. from Joyce Jackson. Subject, wide R.
Crooked has big hips, big thighs, big stomach, and a big butt. Good thing love is blind, or Danny would have her on a diet. There's another one in here about Leanna's clothes. It says she wears anything in spandex, or all her clothes look like they've been shrunk, or she's had them since she was 10.
Karen enjoys the soap opera bulletin board. Diligently on the computer, I'll look outside and see what has happened. Oh my goodness, it's snowing. Snowing as we speak. This is the kind of snow they get up here in New York. It's fast. It's called Lake Effect Snow. It comes off Lake Ontario. We're not supposed to get that much tonight. Just want to understand. There's the Valiant.
Shot.
Well, she's made a big mess. That's one thing I found out about being a cat owner. If you're going to be a cat owner, be used to having a mess.
He eats the whole mushroom, but he leaves just like little chewed pieces.
But it's worth to us to have the have a mess. To have our little Harry.
The cat, he's a vegetarian cat.
If you think that this cat is crazy about mushrooms, you should see when we get the peas out. Last night we got peas. We made peas, the cats were going crazy. He eats cats.
He's a vegetarian cat.
I think all food processes cheese and nothing to do with it.
What about this one, they ask?
Yeah,
where is he? He's like a little rat. Snow rabbit! Snow rabbit! Snow rabbit! Snow rabbit. I've trained him.
By the way, Karen, I'd like to wish everyone happy Merry Christmas, Happy New Year. I would like to wish everyone in the world Merry Christmas and Happy New Year.
This is like a doctor's commercial, except I'm filming your head really close instead of...
Yeah, you need to move the camera a lot more, and I need to say really stupid things, and I need to say stuff like wimp. We tried to get the kite out, but there was no wimp.
But I'm filming your mouth instead.
Instead of the
logo on the back of your pants.
I've been acquiring don't focus on my mouth.
Okay, I'll focus on your arm.
I've been acquiring a New York accent since I've been here, because people like Fred Drums. We talk like this, kind of, in a nasal kind of way. Fred Drums.
Oh, you're kidding!
That kind of voice. I'm good at grating cheese, though. Background, Ella Fitzgerald, live in Rome.
Snow Rabbit.
Got a lot of stuff out of the library.
Snow Rabbit!
Of course, don't mind me. Cat is the number one thing to focus on here. Did anyone
anyone else notice that there was a glitch, though, in the opening credits? That the production company had said that it was produced by Wooly the Sheep, or someplace on Wooly Sheep, it was Wooly, they left out the E. Unless that was the German, might be the German spelling. I'm not exactly sure. I can't tell these foreign films.
They never make any sense.
Think it's time to get that quest out?
Yep.
Okay.
Your first regulation?
I went to the first grade when I was 5 years old because my father was a teacher. And I think my mother wanted to get rid of me.
Mm-hmm.
And the first thing I can remember was the big time of that year was the teacher was very ugly and not a very good teacher. And so one of my friends, she said something to him and he didn't like it. So he took his tin box, dinner box, and hit her over the head with it. And she was out of school for 2 weeks, and her sister came and taught in her place. And her sister was real pretty, blonde, and all the children liked her, but they didn't take care of the other one. So that was the first thing I remember growing up.
That's a Christmas present from a very dear friend of mine.
Quite a lovely Jackson Pollock, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
What does it say to you?
It restates the negativeness of the universe, the hideous, lonely emptiness of existence, nothingness, the predicament of man forced to live in a barren, godless eternity, like a tiny flame flickering in an immense void with nothing but waste, horror and degradation forming a useless, bleak straitjacket in a black, absurd cosmos.
What are you doing Saturday night?
Committing suicide.
What about Friday night?